Hey PC World fans, Adam here. If you've been eyeing one of the big name high performance portable SSD drives but don't want to pay the high prices, just build your own. In this video, I'm going to show you how. This video is sponsored by SK Hynix, the maker of fastest in class SSDs. SK Hynix developed the world's first 128 layer NAND based consumer SSD and is the world's second largest memory manufacturer. But what really sets them apart is incredible performance at affordable prices, surprising power efficiency, and 5-year warranties. In fact, SK Hynix makes PC World's top picks for best all around SSD and best NVMe SSD. Grab the Gold P31 or S31 on Amazon and give your PC a big upgrade. Yes, you can skip those big brand prices by building your own portable SSD using off-the-shelf parts, getting the same performance, and typically a lower price as well. You'll first want to pick out a USB SSD enclosure, which can be found on Newegg, Amazon, and other electronic stores for around $10 to $50. Before you shop though, you'll want to know what kind of enclosure to buy. Much of that depends on what kind of SSD you want to put inside of it. There's 2.5 inch SATA SSDs like this SK Hynix Gold S31. These offer very good speeds, which can reach about 560 megabyte per second reads, but fall short of even faster M.2 PCIe or NVMe SSDs. If you want to build your own USB portable drive to rival the high-end big brand portable SSDs, you'll want to buy a PCIe or NVMe SSD enclosure. While both types are equally as easy to make, and the 2.5 inch SATA SSD is usually more than enough, I'm gonna focus on an NVMe drive in this video. For my example, I'll be building a drive using an Asus ROG Strix Arion enclosure, mostly because it has RGB for maximum flare. With an SK Hynix Gold P31 NVMe SSD inside, it can reach the maximum bandwidth out of USB 3.2 Gen 2 interfaces. That's basically around 1 GB per second. Like all USB drives, it's backwards compatible with USB 3.0 and USB 2.0, and this enclosure comes with both USB-C and USB Type-A cables. To build it, first reduce any static electricity by touching a metal object such as a furniture leg. To install the M.2 SSD, use the included pick tool and insert it into the small pinhole near the USB port to pop the cover open. Put the cover aside and try not to touch the sticky thermal pads on the lid. The thermal pads help wick heat from the high performance SSD into the aluminum body and help maintain performance. Unscrew the silver retention screw inside the enclosure. If it's too tight, use the handle of the pick tool to loosen it. Now take the M.2 SSD and insert it at a 15 degree angle into the slot in the enclosure. The side with the stickers is usually the top of the drive, and the side that gets inserted is the one with the exposed contacts with the notch in it. The semicircle notch is the side that the retention screw will hold down. Insert the drive gently but firmly until the gold contacts are not visible. Now take the retention screw and seat it into the notch of the semicircle of the M.2 drive. Tilt the drive down and screw the retention screw in place snugly. Take the cover of the enclosure and line it up along the edge away from the USB port and tilt it into place. If the lid won't go on, you may want to make sure that you have the drive in the notch of the retention screw and not simply under it. With the lid on, slip on the rubber bumper and grab the cable you want to use. The cable with two USB-C connectors will allow the highest performance. This Gold P31 can reach faster speeds than what USB offers, so we are limited by the enclosure here, not the drive. Just remember, the drive and the enclosure aren't the only things that determine how fast you can move files. The port you plug into matters as well. Generally, most laptops or desktop computers that will accept USB-C will usually offer the most speed. The older but far more common USB Type-A can vary from very slow to very fast. One final step you may need to do before it's recognized by Windows is to provision it from within Windows. Press the Windows key plus X and select Disk Management. Disk Management should show you the drives attached to your computer, one of which will say unallocated for your new drive. And yes, make absolutely sure you are not selecting the primary drive of the PC you are using or another drive you don't intend to format. Right mouse click on the drive that says unallocated and select new simple volume. Select next and then choose the volume size you want. Windows should default to the full drive capacity. Click next and then next to assign the drive path. The last window should be format partition.
click next and then finish, and Windows will partition and format your new drive for you. Boom! Your portable SSD is now ready for use, and this one has RGB for even more nerd cred. Well, that's it for this tutorial, but be sure to subscribe to PC World for even more awesome PC hardware videos.